After spending some quality time with the iPhone 12 mini, I am extremely impressed. And not only the obvious, like the small size and the weight, but it actually outperforms my 12 Pro Max in multiple ways that I was not expecting, which I'll cover in just a bit. Hey guys, it's Max. In this video, I will cover every single difference that I found when I ditched my 12 Pro Max and swapped over to the 12 mini. And I have to be honest, I am quite torn at this point which one I should use long term because I love them both. My SIM is currently in the Pro Max, but I'm gonna be swapping back to the mini, and here's why. Let's get the most obvious out of the way at the start. This thing feels absolutely incredible in the hand. Sure, the 12 and 12 Pro are also smaller than the Max, but to me, the size difference doesn't make a big enough effect on comfort to make it worth it, but it absolutely does with the mini. Now go ahead and let me know down in the comments if you're like me and you love using your phone when you're laying in bed late at night or early in the morning. Now it might seem trivial, but the 12 mini is amazing for this. Not only do my hands not get tired when I'm holding it out watching videos, but when the inevitable time comes and you drop it as you doze off, trust me, it hurts nowhere near as bad as the Max. And that's because the 12 Pro Max weighs close to twice as much as the mini. Now, okay, that might be obvious, but if you do the math, the Pro Max's display is technically only 25% larger, while the phone weighs 75% more. So that is an impressive difference. With that, the 12 mini doesn't feel cheap at all like most small lightweight phones do. It still feels substantial and premium. And if you want it to be even more comfortable in the hand, there's one accessory that makes it feel out of this world, and that is this, Apple's overpriced wallet case. I know it's gotten a lot of hate with people saying it falls off too easily, and that's only partially true. On my 12 Pro Max, it is honestly a pain. It's constantly twisting, and every so often it falls off when I'm putting it in my pockets or taking it out. But with the mini, it is phenomenal. Not only does it fill in the little space between the phone and your hand, making the phone fit perfectly, it also provides more grip and gives you that nice feel of the natural leather without covering the premium sides like you would with a case. And because it aligns perfectly with the frame, it doesn't twist, and I haven't had it fall off even once because there is no gap between the back and the wallet like you have with the Max. If you have or you're getting a mini, I would definitely give it a shot, and if it's too pricey, I'll link some cheaper alternatives in the description. But with that said, I probably wouldn't recommend it for the Max. So we talked about size, weight, and comfort, and now let's talk about people's biggest concern when buying a mini, the battery life. The Max weighs 75% more than the mini, and the battery is 60% larger than the mini's. And at the same time, it has a power display that is not only larger, but it also has 44% more pixels and one that also gets brighter. So what was my real world experience with battery life? To be honest, it wasn't as bad as I was expecting. Now yes, the Max smokes it, but I expected the mini to be dead by 3 p.m. every day, like my old iPhone 6s when I had it, but it was quite a bit better. Even with my heavy use, the 12 Pro Max lasts me all day just like the 11 Pro Max, and it usually has between 10 to 20% battery life when I set it down to charge at night. When I was using the 12 Pro, it would reach close to 0% somewhere between 6 and 7 p.m., so I'd have to charge it midday. Surprisingly, the 12 mini was only about an hour worse with my typical usage patterns, getting low between 5 to 6 p.m. And I don't know about you, if I have to top off during the day, it doesn't really matter if it's an hour earlier. With that, it also charges faster than the 12 with a 20 watt, being almost at 100% in 1 hour. And even though it only accepts 12 watts for MagSafe charging, it charges just as fast as the iPhone 12 because its battery is smaller. If you're a heavy user and you still want a full day's battery like I do, the Max is your only option. But if you're a light user or you don't mind popping your phone on a wireless charger during the day or topping off, the mini's battery was way better than I expected. But with that said, there's not always such a big battery gap between the mini and the Pro Max. When I was gaming, the battery life between the two were surprisingly much closer, just over an hour of difference, which didn't really make sense to me, at least at first. Both of these phones have very similar performance since both of them have the same 5nm A14 Bionic chip. I ran some tests and a Geekbench. Interestingly, the Max consistently got 2 to 400% more points in CPU, but the graphics are nearly identical. Because of that, this is the most powerful tiny phone when it comes to gaming on the market, and it could play any iOS game at full settings. But what really surprised me is how it performed compared to the 12 Pro Max. I maxed out all of the settings playing Call of Duty Mobile, and I had no issues at all, even after a long gaming session, and the back of the phone didn't get as hot as my 12 Pro Max. And it also played very consistently, which I wasn't expecting. I thought that it would get too hot with the same powerful A14 Bionic in such a small body, and the screen would end up automatically dimming to cut down on the heat, but it didn't. This is the biggest annoyance with my 12 Pro Max. If I max out my game settings, after about a half hour, it gets very hot and the screen locks at less than half brightness, but the Mini doesn't seem to have that issue. The only explanation that I can think of is that the much larger display of the Max puts out a lot more heat, and with that, it has 44% more pixels, which means the graphics have to work harder and heat up more. And with that, since the Mini has less pixels, you might think that it is less detailed, but because it's smaller, it's actually Apple's most detailed screen with a pixel density of 476 ppi compared to 458. But enough with the praises for the Mini. Let's get into the biggest issues that I discovered, and here is the most annoying thing for me personally. The display quality is amazing. HDR video looks fantastic thanks to the sharp OLED display, but the speakers just don't match up to the fantastic display. Take a listen for yourself. The mids miss a lot of richness and the bass is pretty much non-existent, so you're seeing a gorgeous late 2020 image, but the sound is from a 2016 iPhone. Now, of course, you can use headphones, especially if you're watching by yourself, but my other complaint is the display size, which maybe I shouldn't even bring up since you know you're buying a small phone, but the difference in immersion between these phones is massive. Where the screen size matters even more is when you're playing games. Although the phone doesn't get as hot, the gaming experience is so much better on the Pro Max, especially in competitive games, because my thumbs take up so much screen and everything is much smaller on the Mini. Taking this further, even when I'm texting, at times I hit the wrong buttons because the keyboard is so much smaller on the Mini. But if you have small hands, of course, that shouldn't be an issue. As far as most other use cases, I was surprised that the smaller screen doesn't matter as much as I expected. For most optimized websites, you don't see that much more info on the Pro Max. Everything is just smaller on the Mini, so the extra screen real estate isn't really used to its full potential on Max. Now, I do find myself holding the phone a little bit closer to my face than with the Max to compensate, and that also ties into RAM and being a power user. The 12 Mini has 4GB of RAM, just like the 12, whereas the Pro models have 6GB, and it's been a great improvement from last year's 11 Pro, where some background apps would have to reload when I tried to switch back to them. So did I notice that issue with the Mini? Honestly, not really. It could be that I didn't use it long enough, or maybe iOS was more optimized, but with that, the times that I would most often push multitasking is when I'm away from my Max in the evening. But in those times, I found myself picking up my iPad way more often, which makes sense. With the 12 Pro Max, the screen is so big that you don't really want or need to use an iPad. But with the Mini, the size difference between it and even an iPad Mini is massive. So if you have an iPad or you want to buy one, I think you'll definitely use it much more if you have a small phone like the 12 Mini. The last thing that I want to cover are the cameras. because we're going from the smallest, cheapest iPhone to the biggest, best one with triple cameras and larger sensors. There are some features that I know I'll miss, like nighttime portrait mode shots and the better quality of the zoom images, but for the vast majority of the shots I take, the quality difference is very minimal thanks to the Mini having the same quality as even the 12 Pro in most cases. I actually did a very in-depth comparison showing every single camera difference between the 12, 12 Pro, and 12 Pro Max, both the good and the bad, and the 12 Mini has the same cameras as the 12, so if you guys want to see it, you can click right over there. As for me, I'm going to put my SIM back into the Mini and try to make up my mind on which phone is more worth it, since I love big phones, but this thing is so convenient to use. Let me know your thoughts down below and click that circle above if you want to subscribe to see my 12 Pro Max long-term review, and I'll see you guys in the next video.